Militants from the Islamic State group have seized Qarakosh, the biggest Christian town in Iraq. It's thought that some 200,000 people have fled fighting there in recent days. Meanwhile, bombs went off in the capital and the oil town of Kirkuk, killing dozens. And we can speak live now to Richard Becker from the Answer Coalition. Thanks for just taking the time to join us, Richard. The militants, they've already seized a handful of towns in just the last 24 hours, including the country's largest dam. I mean, they are rampant at the moment. It seems that neither the Kurdish forces nor the government can do much about it to stop them. Why do you think they're enjoying what appears to be such incredible momentum?
Well, there's no question but that it was the intervention of the United States in Iraq and also the U.S. and its partners in Syria, which laid the groundwork for the ISIS organization to develop. I mean, we should remember just in 2010 or 2011, they themselves say they carried out 6 actions in the whole year. They were practically defunct before the United States and its allies supported the opposition, the armed opposition inside Syria, and gave an opening to this organization to develop and then to come back into Iraq. And of course, it was the intervention of the United States in Iraq to begin with that destabilized the country in such a terrible way and has led to what is really a tragic situation in Iraq and a tragic situation in Syria as well.
Okay, what about the possibility of further intervention? Because the White House is mulling airstrikes against the militants. In your opinion, are they likely to be effective?
Well, we in the Answer Coalition are opposed to any further U.S. intervention. We, from the very beginning of the Iraq War in 2003, warned of the potential consequences. Of course, we could not know the specifics, but the consequences would be horrific for the people of Iraq. And now the idea that the United States would come back in again holds no greater promise of a better situation or better life for the people of Iraq than it did back then.
I mean, you just mentioned that you think, you know, further involvement would be horrific. I mean, in particular, what do you think the consequences could be of American intervention?
Well, there, what will move the United States government to intervene will not be humanitarian concerns, but rather a fear of losing all that they had hoped to build up, what was really a dependent client government in Iraq. The seizure of the dam is extremely serious for the people of Iraq because it gives ISIS, which is a thoroughly reactionary organization, the possibility to both flood areas of the country and deprive people of water. But this is something that the Iraqi people have to deal with. And the Maliki government is not a government that can deal with it. The Iraqi people need a government that can fight for the interest of the Iraqi people against this reactionary organization.
Okay, at this juncture, I'd just like to take a quick look at the finances involved, and in particular, the cost of the previous Iraqi war, how much that cost America. Because the White House, they spent a whopping $1.7 trillion on the whole ordeal. That's works out at $5,000 per second. Each American soldier costs $350,000 to deploy, and the government still owes billions to those who actually fought there for their country. It's an extremely expensive business. And bearing that in mind, do you think that the taxpayers would allow their government to get involved in what is sure to be another costly war?
Well, I think it's been very clear that the people in the United States, after the Iraq War and the Afghanistan War, which is, of course, still ongoing, but particularly the Iraq War, are opposed to any new U.S. intervention in the Middle East. That became clear at the time of the near intervention last September into Syria. So, you know, and as you said, the cost of the war has not really been added up yet in terms of the damage done in Iraq, the damage done to people who fought in it from the United States, and the actual cost, which will be ongoing, and hundreds of billions, if not trillions of dollars, will be added to that in terms of healthcare in the future. And I think people are quite aware of that now, of what a catastrophe that war was for the people in Iraq and also for the people in the United States.
Okay, thanks so much for joining us and just giving us your thoughts on the situation. Speaking to Richard Becker from the Answer Coalition. Thanks so much.